Metaphors are an incredibly useful type of figurative language that can add so much depth and beauty to your writing. But even if you know what a metaphor is technically, and you can recognize one when you see it, writing a good one is sometimes easier said than done. Metaphor is simply a figure of speech that describes something by implying or stating that it is actually something else. Metaphors are not literal. They're understood to be a comparison. For example, if you wrote the line, "Her heart was an ice-cold rock," we know this character doesn't actually have an ice-cold rock in her chest. The implication is that she's unloving and unfeeling. This is similar to a simile, but while a simile uses like or as to make it clear that this is a comparison, a metaphor does not. Her voice was as smooth as silk is a simile. Her voice slipped over my skin, soft and silky, is a metaphor. The biggest mistake I see writers make when it comes to including metaphors in their story is that they're so caught up in writing the metaphor itself that they end up with something that might work on its own, but doesn't really fit with the tone and, most importantly, the voice of the story. Remember, this isn't your metaphor, this is your narrator's metaphor. How would they describe this thing? And what would they compare it to? What metaphor best fits their personality, their beliefs, their worldview? Try this exercise and I guarantee you will immediately see what I'm talking about. Take these three characters: a bitter old wizard, an aloof movie star, and a noble spaceship captain. Keep in mind that these three characters already obviously have very different personalities, but they're also in different genres of story. Now, take 3 minutes and describe the following three things from each of those characters' points of view using a metaphor, and make sure you compare it to something that they would be familiar with. A crumbling old castle, a sleek Lamborghini, Jupiter. What would a bitter old wizard compare Jupiter to, compared to an aloof movie star? What would come to a spaceship captain's mind upon seeing a crumbling old castle? Certainly something very different than what the wizard would compare it to. These three characters would each describe these three things with very different metaphors, shaped by their experiences and their worldview. And that's how you write a good metaphor. Stop trying to be overly clever or overly original and get into your narrator's headspace. See the thing that you're trying to describe through his or her or their eyes. Let them make the comparison and you've got a truly original metaphor that adds depth and meaning to your story. Here's a little bit of foreshadowing for you. Next week's Fiction Fix It is going to be all about foreshadowing. I didn't do that right. So make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know when that video goes up. Also, if you do this exercise, please, please share your metaphors in the comments below. And if you come up with any other different characters or different objects for them to describe using metaphors, I would love to read them. If you found this video helpful, I would very much appreciate it if you would hit that like button. And I will see you next Friday with another Fiction Fix It. Until then, keep writing.